Welcome to the Boeing 747-400 cockpit overview. This is Captain James Weatherly. I had the privilege of operating the Boeing 747 all over the world for KLM. I also served as an instructor pilot for Atlas in the cargo version of the Boeing 747-400. When this aircraft was introduced, there were radical changes from the classic 747. There was a two-pilot crew. It had full FMS integration, complete aircraft systems automation, carbon fiber brakes, increased thrust, increased altitude capability, stabilizer fuel, and lower fuel burn. Well, for those of us who have been around for a while, we learned to fly on something like this. Pilots soon nicknamed this as steam-powered from the old steam locomotives, and we learned to switch to the new cockpit, which was quickly nicknamed a glass cockpit. Wow, what a difference. This is the cockpit of a 747-400. Complete difference from the old 747. Another major difference was the removal of the flight engineer's panel, where a crew member had operated all the aircraft systems. Now that was replaced by an overhead system fully automated and run by a computer. It's easy to see for even a novice observer there's a major change in the cockpit. Instead of all the little instruments, there are six large CRTs which display all the different information to the pilots. In this overview, we're going to look at each one of those CRT groupings and how they display information along with some of the other controls. The first group that we'll look at is the Pfds. That stands for Primary Flight Displays. These take the six basic flight instruments that the pilot was looking at, group it into one CRT for a display. There's a lot of information on this display. You have airspeed, attitude, altitude, heading, course, autopilot information. It's a large amount of information. It took me almost 12 months of flying these PFDs to realize all the information, because you also have trend indicators, navigational information. But once you learn to fly this way, you can fly far more accurately because the information that's given to the pilot is so much better. The next section we'll look at is the NDs, or navigational display. It's a pictorial representation of your route, your heading, plus all the applicable radio aids and airports, all in one combined screen. Now, as part of this, there's the Indy selector switch, where the pilot can select his display, which type of display, the range of the display, an altimeter setting, decision height. He can also select would he like to display airports, certain types of radio navigation aids, waypoints. He can also ask to display the IRS actual position, all controlled from his ND selector switch. The two remaining screens are referred to as the upper and lower EICAS. They're part of the overall EICAS system, which is an acronym for Engine Indications Crew Alerting System. This is a system implemented in the 757-767 program. A computer system monitors the entire airplane, advises the pilots of any change, or warns them of any impending problem. It will identically match their checklist, so it's a simple resolution to any potential problem or action that's required. Now let's look at the upper EICAS. The upper EICAS provides the basic function of engine indications, how the jet engines are performing. Now you notice the blank on the upper right hand side. That's where the EICAS messages appear. Here's what they look like. That blue box shows them in the yellow. Here everything's off, so you have lots of warning messages. But these are the messages that tell you which checklist to go to. It's a completely automated system, and there are various levels of EICAS messages. Now the lower system is a pop-up system. It basically provides aircraft system information for hydraulics, pneumatics, fuel, landing gears, anything. Now there is a lower EICAS selector buttons there on the right of the mode control panel. Here is the MCP, or mode control panel, that controls the autoflight system. or what we used to call the autopilot. It's fully integrated with a FMS flight management system computers. Allows the pilot to control virtually everything, the engines, the aircraft speed, the lateral navigation, vertical navigation, the heading, the angle of bank, vertical speed, altitude, just about anything. It's also where he accesses the triple channel Category 3C capable autopilot. That means this aircraft can land in 00 weather. I've actually performed those landings in Amsterdam Schiphol Airport and does an awesome job. The two smaller screens with green letterings are the CDUs, the control display units for the FMS, the flight management system. The 400 has a total integrated flight management system that takes the routing, the aircraft weight, the performance, the engines, all in one, controls the airplane automatically. It's a tremendous system. It's accessed through the CDU, that's the one with the green letters, where the pilot does the input of the information and also reads the output. And it's integrated with the mode control panel and the engine control unit. In the engine control area, you have EECs, electronic engine control. The throttles move together perfectly, and you have automatic engine starting, which we'll cover more in the overhead panel discussion. Now let's look at the automated overhead panel, where the functions that were previously housed at the flight engineer station have been relocated. Here's an overview of the different sections. In the top left, you have the IRS control. That's for inertial reference system. Provides the laser-based system to provide positioning information to the flight management system. Below that, you have the electrical system. It's a totally automated load shedding and electrical problem solution, all in one, tied into the EICAS system. Below are the hydraulics. Similar to the classics, you have both engine-driven and air-driven pumps, providing hydraulic pressure for flight controls, landing gear, steering, etc. Now, above there, in the middle section, you have the fire protection. It works just like any other jet airplane. You have handles, they light up, bells go off, you pull them, you twist them, it fires the bottle. No difference. Below that, you have the engine start controls. A big difference. Complete automatic starting, and you can start two engines at the same time. If you have a problem, it solves all the problem. You simply will let it go and watch it. The fuel jettison system. Fuel dumping is easy. If you buy the option max landing weight, you need to dump fuel. You just press the button. It takes care of everything automatically. Even shows you a kitchen timer on the upper EICAS screen so you know exactly what's happening. Fuel system is below that. It's also very automated and has the option of a horizontal stab tank for additional fuel and extended range. Upper right is the pressurization system. It's fully automated, takes all its information from the FMS. Right below that is the PAX and the pneumatic system. One of the great things about that, in the passenger configuration, they finally put a thermostat where the flight attendants are. Well, that's your brief overview of the Boeing 747-400. I hope you've enjoyed this. I hope if you're a pilot, you get a chance to fly. I've certainly enjoyed flying the 400. It's a great airplane. Thank you. Have a great time.